Good morning, everybody, and welcome to our Mass here at Church of Our Lady Star of the Sea in Barryroe Parish, and welcome to those who join us too on live stream this morning. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. A couple of things running through the themes of the Mass this morning, I suggest for reflection. Absolutely, Christ is the Good Shepherd, the Shepherd. And after his example, he is a man of prayer, engaging with his Father, Abba, and calls us to do the same as we do this morning, to come apart, to pray for multiple things, enrichment of our faith in the person of Christ. We call to mind our need for God's healing touch, forgiveness, just renewal of his life in us. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart, Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners, Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. We pray in this Mass with family and friends for the late Patricia Truscott, nee Hayes of Grangemore and Bandon, whose first anniversary occurs. Show favour, O Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, we may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, for ever and ever. A reading from the prophet Jeremiah. Doom for the shepherds who allow the flock of my pasture to be destroyed and scattered. It is the Lord who speaks. This, therefore, is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says about the shepherds in charge of my people. You have let my flock be scattered and go wandering, and have not taken care of them. Right, I will take care of you for your misdeeds. It is the Lord who speaks. But the remnant of my flock, I myself, will gather from all the countries where I have dispersed them. and will them bring them back to their pastures. They shall be fruitful and increase in numbers. I will raise up shepherds to look after them and pasture them. No fear, no terror for them anymore. Not one shall be lost, is the Lord who speaks. See, the days are coming, it is the Lord who speaks, when I will raise a virtuous branch for David, who will reign as true king and be wise, practicing honesty and integrity in the land. In his days, Judah will be saved and Israel dwell in confidence. And this is the name he will be called, the Lord our integrity. The word of the Lord. Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. In Christ Jesus, you that used to be far apart from us have been brought very close by the blood of Christ. For he is the peace between us and has made the two into one and broken down the barrier which used to keep us apart, keep them apart, actually destroying in his own person the hostility caused by the rules and decrees of the law. This was to create one single new man in himself out of the two of them, and by restoring peace through the cross to unite them both in a single body and reconcile them with God. In his own person, he killed the hostility. Later he came to bring the good news of peace, peace to you who are far away and peace to you who are near at hand. Through him, both of us have in the one spirit our way to come the Father. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The sheep that belong to me listen to my voice, says the Lord. I know them and they follow me. The Lord be with you. Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. The apostles rejoined Jesus and told him all they had done and taught. Then he said to them, "You must come away to some lonely place all by yourselves and rest for a while." For there were so many coming and going that the apostles had no time even to eat. So they went off in a boat to a lonely place where they could be by themselves. But people saw them going, and many could guess where. And from every town they all hurried to the place on foot and reached it before them. So as Jesus stepped ashore, he saw a large crowd. And he took pity on them, for they were like sheep without a shepherd. And he set himself to teach them at some length. The Gospel of the Lord. Those last few lines always caused me to smile. He began to teach them at some length. Every Sunday for reflection, you may not think it, but there's always a little bit of nervousness that I experience. I think it's a bit healthy. Keeps me a bit on my toes. But I'm always confident God is doing something special, walking in and through me, if I get out of the way. So, one of the things that I reflect on this morning for us is the gift of prayer. All sorts of formats of prayer within the church. You may have your favorite. The one that's most common, of course, as a family of God, is the Our Father. Jesus spoke in terms of the intimacy with his Father as Abba. It was actually one of the things that really disturbed the leadership and the followers of the law and so on of his time, that he addressed God as his Father. Every day, since I got a little card from some, I don't know where it came from, I got a little card, a prayer card, many, many years ago, I think before ordination. Could have been from my grandmother. And I say this prayer every day. I used to say it at communion time, but in the changed way we celebrate Mass of recent times, I don't get a chance to say it, so I say it maybe even more often, multiple times during the day. I have the words in front of me in case I forget. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my hands and let them move at the impulse of thy love. Take my feet and let them be swift and beautiful for thee. Take my voice and let it sing always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from thee. Take my heart, it is thine own, let it be thy royal throne. Take my will and make it thine, it shall be no longer mine. And yourselves, your prayer, your coming apart, your wish to be his, the challenge to do so not just on Sunday, but regularly, morning and evening. It influences actually all of the self in relation to God, to each other, to nature, to everything, mind, body, heart, and spirit. The shepherd. Jesus sent out the disciples and they came back. They did his work. They were about doing his work, preaching the gospel. Salvation, repentance, and life in Christ. And like any of us in nature of humanity, we get tired. We're fulfilled, but sometimes we get tired. Or maybe we need to be renewed in spirit and heart. And so Jesus says, come along, rest, pray. The wisdom of the teacher. The wisdom of the good shepherd. No point in pointing to the people of the past and the Old Testament, perhaps, and the shepherds that didn't do so, because we look, and our eyes are on Christ himself. So we look to the good shepherd to hear his voice near restful waters to revive our spirit. Coincidentally, during the week, I came across this prayer. Might be familiar to you. The difference of prayer. I got up early one morning and rushed right into the day. I had so much to accomplish that I didn't have time to pray. Problems just tumbled about me, and heavier came each task. Why doesn't God help me? I wondered. He answered, you didn't ask. I wanted to see joy and beauty, but the day toiled on, grey and bleak. I wondered why God didn't show me, he said, but you didn't seek. I tried to come into God's presence. I used all kinds of keys at the lock. God gently and lovingly shouted, my child, you didn't knock. I woke up early this morning and paused before entering the day. I had so much to accomplish that I had to take time to pray. We profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory, will judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, life, the world to come. Amen. So we pray. Pray for ourselves and with generosity for all God's people. For leaders of the faith community at all levels, may we be authentic to the gospel. Lord, hear us. May we do so, preach the gospel so freely and be an example to all. Lord, hear us. For the times when leadership of the faith community have indeed failed, we ask for forgiveness and healing Lord, hear us. For the gift of peace and reconciliation in Christ, the peace the world cannot give, Lord, hear us. For a sense of appreciation and gratitude, Lord, hear us. With generosity, we pray for those in any type of need. Perhaps they may not even be able to pray for themselves. We pray for them. Mind, heart, body, and spirit, the Lord may accompany them. Lord, hear us. For the gift itself of prayer, of reflection, of challenge. Lord, hear us. And we pause for a moment to present something of ourselves, something of thanksgiving or petition. Lord, hear us. For welcoming to God's kingdom of the souls of the faithful departed, parishioners, relatives, friends, those we think of every now and again. Recently deceased, Audrey Crowley, Dublin, John Johart, Court McSherry and Timmy League, Jerry Collins, Shannock, Butlestown and Knockbrown, Bandon, Bernie O'Donovan, Toreen, Ballinhassig, Doreen Scannell, Court McSherry, for anniversaries and otherwise remembered at this time, Kitty Callahan, Birmingham and Court McSherry, whose first anniversary occurs, Aveen Harrington, Shannock, Eileen Butler, Tipperary and Cork, Billy Newman, Blackpool and Middleton, Sil Dineen, Ballinbrokig, Bucklestown, Maureen McKenna, Court McSherry, and with family and friends today, for the late Patricia Truscott, Nee Hayes, of Grange Moor and Bandon, first anniversary. Lord, hear us. Now, there are but some of our prayers we make, and we hope in faith that might be granted through Christ our Lord. And it's our prayer that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honour of your majesty may benefit the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, and with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, and without end we acclaim. Eucharistic prayer number 2. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord and Father, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Fintan, our Bishop, clergy, religious, all God's people. Remember Patricia and all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, and all the saints who please you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Appropriately we gather and pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns for ever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, You take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. As you come to receive Holy Communion, please be guided by the stewards. Wait until you're asked to move, okay? Thank you. We have received Holy Communion, privileged to do so. We pray now the prayer of spiritual communion for those who join us on live stream. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, please come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you now as if you were already there, and I unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Behold, I stand at the door and knock, says the Lord. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door to me, I will enter the house and dine with them, and they with me. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you've imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life. Through Christ our Lord. Lord be with you. May my God bless us, the Father, the Son, Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. We go in the peace of Christ to love and serve him. Thanks be to God. Please be guided again by as you leave by the stewards. Thank you.